Monkey D. Luffy, a pirate on a journey to become the Pirate King and ultimately find the One Piece. Luffy and his crew travel the seas in hopes to obtain it, battling against many forces to see himself at his peak. Luffy's strength seems to increase by the second, as Luffy can battle crime lords, false gods, and even the unkillable creature Kaido. Even before the time skip, Luffy's strength was ridiculous. At this point, Luffy would be stronger than Gecko Moria, who can erase entire cities in a single shot. And after the time skip, Luffy is powerful enough to defeat his entire crew from 2 years ago, including himself. With Luffy going on to learn the spiritual technique known as Haki, which gives him the ability to hit intangible things, as well as precognition, or the ability of foresight. And this is just Fishman Island Luffy, who hasn't even shown a fraction of his true strength. In the Dressrosa arc, Luffy is faced with Don Chen Zhao, a fighter that can erase continents from the map. But it's still not enough, as Luffy doesn't even feel it. However, once Luffy faces Doflamingo, this is where it gets much worse, as Doffy easily dismantles Luffy's second and third gears, with Luffy's second gear alone being calculated to be a 10 times increase to Luffy's base strength. But now it's time for his trump card, as Luffy shows us what he can really do, accessing another gear, Bounce Man Luffy, Gear 4. With this, Luffy completely thrashes Doflamingo, and after Luffy overpowers their clash, half of Dressrosa has been torn apart, sending the heavenly demon back to hell. The sun is rising. In Whole Cake Island, Luffy faces Katakuri, the first commander for Emperor of the Sea, and a perfect warrior, with the ability to see into the future, and with a win-loss ratio of 99 wins to 0, with Katakuri being able to overpower Luffy's Gear 4, but he keeps on getting stronger. As Luffy's Haki evolves, he learns the future sight technique in a matter of hours, to the point where Katakuri acknowledges that Luffy is just as strong as him. And he said this to a base form Luffy, meaning Luffy within only a couple of hours got 30 times stronger, or enough to match his previous Gear 4. And Luffy can stack Gear 4 on top of this, making him 60 times stronger than his initial base state. Pretty crazy, Luffy got himself a boost even greater than Super Saiyan. And with Luffy's Snake Man, he's able to completely blitz Katakuri, but it's not over, as his Haki evolves as well. And after 12 consecutive hours of constant fighting, only one warrior arises, almost like the sun. But with the sun, there's always an eclipse, with Luffy taking on the unkillable creature Kaido. All hope seems to be lost, as Luffy's Gear 4 strength is rendered completely useless against Kaido. Kaido sees that even while Luffy is unconscious, he still admits Conqueror's Haki and decides to let him live. What's the worst that can happen? This probably won't come back to bite him, right? After 2 weeks of preparation for the raid on Kaido's castle, Onigashima, on the night of the raid, an army of 5,400 fighters, including the Straw Hats, are here to make Kaido's title a myth. After all hell breaks loose, Zoro Kid, Law Killer, and Luffy make it to the rooftop, but they were far too late. As Luffy looks around and sees all of his dying comrades on the floor, he decides that he's done. Luffy remembers all of the pain and suffering that he's seen with his own two eyes, and walks past two emperors of the seas as if they weren't even there. And now it's time to show these false gods the fruits of their training. As Luffy launches himself into the air, he puts all of that pain and suffering into his fist, and he's going to give it right back, punching Kaido's face into the dirt with a full power red rock. Once again, only using his base form, Luffy outperforms his previous Gear 4 strength, with the weakest generation pushing the two emperors of the seas to transform. However, Kaido's final transformation seems to be the end for this group's luck. In order to preserve Luffy's strength, Zoro steps up and defends his captain, and Zoro is rewarded generously, as he's able to awaken a brand new technique that is able to overpower the unkillable creature. And once Luffy is ready to fight, he's figured out Kaido's little secret. You can infuse yourself with the color of the Supreme King too, right? Luffy is able to figure out how to imbue his attacks with Conqueror's Haki, meaning Luffy has surpassed his fourth gear for the third time, as Luffy performs even better against hybrid Kaido. But Kaido decides to celebrate a little early, as he gets drunk and gets stronger. After shrugging off Luffy's attacks yet again, Luffy has just enough stamina to access his fourth gear for the last time. But this battle is over. After seemingly being killed by Kaido, and everyone believing that he's finished, Luffy's fruit begins to awaken as his heart beats again. His hair turns white as he begins to smile, tapping into something. Well, rising from the grave is the Sun God with Luffy at its peak. The Joy Boy has returned. Gear 5 Luffy. Reaching the awakening stage, this is where the Paramecia type Gum Gum fruit is actually revealed to be the Zoan type human fruit, Model Nika. With this, he's able to accomplish anything he can imagine. Slamming Kaido into the ground and using his body as a jump rope, this fight was straight out of an episode of Tom and Jerry. As when he gets hit, he takes the shape of the club, spins around, and punches straight through Kaido's head. But it's not just Luffy that's being affected, as it seems the entire world is under Luffy's will, almost like the sun. When Kaido shoots his blast breath, Luffy uproots the ground and is able to block it, sending it back like a trampoline. With this new strength far surpassing any of his former gears, he gains the ability to regenerate and was even stated to grow stronger the more he laughs, surpassing Blackbeard, whose darkness is so dense that it attracts anything, and not even light can escape it. With this being counted all the way to star level, however, this might not be as much of a highball as you might think, as Kaido would be relative to Whitebeard, who was stated to be able to destroy the entire One Piece planet, with the One Piece planet itself being calculated to be larger than our own sun. But this is a highball, so I'll let you decide. With Luffy having the power of Toon Force, as he can warp reality, see into the future with Observation Haki, negate durability with Advanced Conqueror's Haki, manipulate the environment with his Paramecia Awakening, and Ridiculous Regen. With Luffy scaling above Zoro, who can dodge Kuma's pad cannons that are stated to reflect air at the speed of light, and even Kizaru, who has light speed attacks. With Luffy getting hundreds of times stronger, surpassing his gears over and over again, Luffy's gotten pretty fast. Overall, Luffy would scale from planetary plus to star level with massively faster than light speeds. In the end, Luffy has come a long way, traveling the seven seas with his crew, and now has a form to make his one wish a reality. But one thing I don't understand is, why would he want to become a king when he's already a god? What's up guys, it's Divine. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you guys like and subscribe and hit that notification bell so you never miss an upload. And make sure you guys go follow the TikTok and join the brand new Discord server. All the links for those will be in the description. I hope to see you guys there. Anyway, tell me in the comments, who is your favorite One Piece character and what do you think of Gear 5? And tell me in the comments, out of the countless characters that you know, who can defeat the Sun God, Gear 5 Luffy?